Today in this lecture I'll be explaining you how to assign a dead load, live load in StatRow. So I first, before designing any structure, you need to just go through the types of loading which you need to assign to any kind of structure, whether it is a RCC structure or steel structures. So for loading details, you can refer to my previous video where I've explained types of load as per Indian standard IS 875. So in this lecture I'll be explaining you the commands how to assign dead load and live load. So once you are done with your modeling, you just need to first you have created this geometry. I've already created a geometry. So now after creating geometry, you just need to click on the general command, where general commands you have these sub commands like material properties, load and load definition, support, specification and property. So in this lecture I'll be just explaining you the dead load and live load assignment in any kind of structure. So just click on load and definitions. So once you click on load and definitions, you'll be getting these three options: definitions, load case details, load envelopes. So load envelopes we are not discussing. Definitions, I'll just go through the load definitions. You need to define few loads like vehicle definitions, time history definitions, wind if you are for wind loading, you need to define wind definitions, snow definitions, seismic definitions. So these are your environmental, basically these are your environmental or your other impact loadings like your vehicle impact push and your seismic loads. Then you just, for your dead load and live load assignment, you just need to click on load case details. So in this load case details, you'll get both the options of individual load assignment and also load combinations. So just click on this and click on add. So once you click on add, you'll be given these four options: primary load generation, defined combination, auto load combination. So for assigning load, individual loads like dead load and live load, you just need to be on this primary command. So once you click on this, you don't need to click on this. This is a default command, the first option, primary. You just need the load type, load number one. This is number of your serial number assigned to your load. Load number one, loading type. So if you click on this, you'll be getting the loading type, whether you are assigning dead load, live load, roof load, wind, seismic, snow. So these are the types of loads which we generally assign on structures. So these you need to just go through this type of load. So first I'll be assigning the dead load. So click on dead load. If your dead load case is load case one, just slide DL or whichever command you want to give, you can just, whichever notation you want to give, you can just give. So once you click on dead DL, you write DL or dead load, you just click on add. So now second load case, live. So today I'll be just explaining dead load and live load. So once you click add, close this. So you have created two loading cases, dead load and live load. Now we need to just understand what all components impart your dead load. So first of all, the self weight of structures. So this is a G+1 RCC building. So in this case, we have not modeled the slab. So the dead load of slab will be assigned in this model. So first of all, self weight. Then you click on dead load, click add. Once you click on add, these options will be available: self weight, nodal load. So your dead load, live load, whichever type of load is there. So these will be either your nodal load, member load, nodal moment or member moment. So first we are just assigning self weight. Click on add self weight. So once you click on self weight, it will generate a self weight command. So just click on self weight. Self weight will be applicable to your entire structure. So just click here, assign to view, because we are assigning to the whole structure. So just assign. So dead load is created, self weight is assigned. Now again, dead load, what we have in dead load, dead load we have wall load. So wall type of your wall, if you have a brick wall, if you have a brick wall, if you have a C4X blocks, depending on their unit weight, you need to just calculate the dead load per meter. That will the dead load of wall on beam will be per meter. So that will be a member load. Nodal load is you have to assign nodal load. Nodal loads are basically your wind load, your earthquake load. These are your nodal load. So we have to assign member load. So once you click on member load, you'll be asked whether you need to assign a uniform force, moment, concentrated force, type of load. If you have a UDL, UVL, whichever type of load, these need to be assigned. So we are just assigning a uniform force. Like just assume 5 kilonewton per meter of UDL due to wall loading on your beam. So just click right here 5. The unit already you have selected. So this the intensity or the direction of this load will be negative because this is in negative y direction, that is downward direction. So once you click on add. Once you click, you have created this node. Again, you just click on this. You have these many options to assign. You can assign to selected beams. You can select those beams and you can assign to view. You can use cursor to assign. So I'll just use cursor to assign and I'll show you. Just click on this assign. You can just click on the individual beam members. So you can keep on assigning this member load. This is your dead load. So once you are done with your member load, so as I said, this model, I have not created a slab, so the slab load will be also generated, the dead load of slab. So again, it will be a slab load won't be a member load, it will be a floor load because it is spreading in a floor. So the intensity, let's see, say we have 1 kilonewton of floor load, that is a dead load of slab. We have just assumed, you can just calculate your values, like thickness of slab, the unit weight of concrete and the area. Then you can use it, you can divide by number of, divide by area, so you'll get per meter square area the load. It will ask you define y range, x range and z range. These are nothing but your coordinates. So y means your height. So on which floor, like I'll just close this. So this, if we want to assign the dead load of slab at this level, so this is the y range. So y range will start, this is 0 0 0, and x range, x is also 0 and z is also 0. So let's just create a floor load. Floor load for dead load for your self weight of slab. So let's just, I have just kept it 0 0. It took the values of this floor load. So in case you have a different types of load, like this level at this point from 0, like let's check the dimension. So at this 18 meter, and this, if you have the slab thickness more and the thickness is decreased in these directions, so the floor loading, the dead load of the floor is different in this area and different in this area. So in that case, you can vary. So where you will vary, you can vary these coordinates, exact coordinates. So you need to just give the range, minimum range and maximum range. So this is the floor loading. So similarly, you can do for your live loading. If you have any other dead load, you can just create, you can do the same thing, you can just create the type of dead load. Like if you have any point load for dead load, like if you have any machines, if you have any equipments, you can just assign nodal load, or you can have a uniform load, then you can just keep on adding. Similarly, once you click on a live load, add. So live loads are basically your floor loads, which is on your acting on your slab most cases. So floor load, just if you have a floor load of 4 kilonewton, just click -4, because -4 is because the load is range. Again, You can vary. If you have a varied range, you can just minimum Y range, maximum Y range. I'll just click on add. Now I've created this, I've created twice. So you can just look, this floor loading has been assigned. If you want to change, like if you want like this I want to have up to 36 meter in Z directions. So from 0 to, let's say 18 meter. So 0 to 18 meter, X range, we have this load. So look, and this I'll change to minimum is 18 to, let's talk what, 40 meter. So just a change. So this has been changed. Previously it was on the entire floor, now it has been changed to this. So you can keep on changing like this. We have 0 to 18. Similarly, you can change in Z direction also. So Z 0 to, let's say 6. So this way you can keep on changing. So this is 0 points, 0 to 6. This also like 6 to 18. I'll keep it 6 to 18. So you can vary this floor load wherever, however you want, you can just vary. So this was regarding your dead load and live load assignment. You can add n number of dead loads. The dead loads, for dead loads, for types of load as per Indian standard, you can refer my previous lectures where I have explained types of loads. You'll get bit better idea regarding the types of load and how. So basically that dead loads are your self weight, your wall load. Those loads will be acting as a dead load. Like dead load is basically the load which is acting throughout the life of your structure, which is not variable, which is not dynamic, it is at rest. So that consists of your dead load. So hope this loading assignment, dead load and live load, is very clear to you. Please comment if you have any queries, if you have any doubts. We will try to clarify, and please try to participate more in the comment, because for a single lecture we require time, we require preparation. So for that, we just, if the participation is more, the request is coming from more number of peoples, then it will be very encouraging to make such videos. So thank you, have a nice day, take care, goodbye, and please subscribe to our channel and keep sharing our videos. Thank you, goodbye.